In the ever-evolving landscape of web design, rounded corners add a nice touch, making things look smoother and friendlier. However, when we start nesting elements with rounded corners, the outcome may appear disjointed. Each corner adds up, and things might not fit together smoothly. In this brief video, we will explore a straightforward solution for perfecting nested rounded corners, followed by a real-world example. But before we dive in, make sure to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell to stay updated on our front-end development tutorials. Let's begin. First of all, let's walk through a simple demo to understand the problem and how an easy CSS solution can fix weird-looking nested rounded corners. For our demo, we have a section with two nested elements placed inside, an outer div and an inner div. Our CSS file begins with some foundational styles for the page. Following that, the demo class is defined as a flex container, ensuring its content is center aligned. The outer div is given a fixed width of 200 pixels, and we utilize the aspect ratio property to ensure it's a perfect square. Additionally, the padding property is used to maintain a gap between both boxes. There are various methods to create this gap, including utilizing the margin property on the inner box. Or, if you are positioning elements, the inset property can also achieve the same effect. Next, the inner div is set with a height of 100% to cover all available space. This is quite a basic setup that employs some presentational styles, avoiding unnecessary complexity. Now let's delve into the issue we occasionally face with nested rounded corners. We begin by applying a border radius property to the outer element. Subsequently, the inner box can inherit the same value from its parent. Upon inspecting the current design, the corners appear unnatural. Despite using the same border radius for both divs, the inner radius looks awkward and oversized. Of course, if you have a specific design requirement that calls for such an effect, there's no need for adjustments. However, if you aim for a more aesthetically pleasing appearance, using the same value for the border radius of both elements may not suffice. There are various approaches to rectify this issue. One method involves adjusting the border radius property for the inner box to find an optimal value. But there should be a more stable and simpler solution than that. The primary factor influencing the appearance is the gap between the two elements. Before proceeding further, let's store these values in custom properties. This will facilitate easy updates in the future, as we can simply call these variables wherever necessary. The gap variable will replace the padding, while the radius will correspond to the border radius property. If you are interested in diving deeper into CSS custom properties, feel free to explore our dedicated video on the topic. Next, the inner box can employ a simple formula to calculate a perfect value for its border radius. The trick here is to subtract the gap from the border radius of the outer element. In other words, the outer radius should equal the sum of the gap and the inner radius. Now let's experiment with the values for a test run. As you can see, we can easily achieve better-looking rounded corners with this simple technique. And it's important to note that this solution may not always yield the desired result in extreme cases where the values don't align. For instance, if the gap is bigger than the radius. Let's now turn our attention to a real-world scenario. This time, we are dealing with a list of people, each represented by a card layout containing an image and some associated content. In the CSS, the parent div is styled as a grid container. The grid template columns property employs an elegant solution for responsive columns, ensuring a minimum width of 260 pixels for each column. Following that, each card is configured as a flex container to properly align its content. The image within the card is assigned a fixed dimension of 60 by 60, with the object fit property set to cover to ensure it maintains the original aspect ratio. Now let's extend the same logic to the nested border radius. As you might expect, we will introduce CSS variables for the gap and the border radius values. Subsequently, the padding property on the outer element will incorporate the gap, while the radius variable will go with the border radius property. Furthermore, the image container will feature its own border radius, calculated using the formula we discussed earlier. As expected, this straightforward solution yields a naturally appealing combination of inner and outer rounded corners. In conclusion, perfecting nested rounded corners in CSS can enhance the aesthetics of our web design. By leveraging this simple technique of adjusted border radius values, we can achieve a harmonious and visually pleasing layout. A few lines of CSS can guarantee nested rounded corners that always look great. If you found this tip helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more exciting tips and tricks. Thanks for watching.